Hey there, it's Anais from Your Curiosity. Now, I don't know about you, but I always enjoy watching channel year in review videos, and so I'm going to be extremely self-indulgent today, and I'm going to tell you what's happened in 2016, give quite a few thank yous, and what's to come in 2017. And fear not, there are plenty of science videos underway if this isn't quite for you. Your Curiosity officially launched in May this year, but to be honest, the idea has existed for far longer. Ever since I was little, I loved nature and maths, and I had always wanted to make my own documentaries. But in spite of that, it took me a very long time to get started. 18 years to be exact. To be perfectly honest, I lacked a lot of self-confidence, but we're not going to go into that. The good news is that earlier this year, I finally had a significant change in mindset, and I decided to follow that dream. I'm not really sure why it took me so long, nor how come it happened so suddenly, but I'm really glad that it did happen. It was January 2016, I went to SICKBE to present my PhD research, SICKBE being a huge conference in America, and I had an absolute blast. Whilst I was there, I attended a science communication workshop, and long story short, I wasn't that bad at it, and I also got to meet Mark Abrahams, who, in case you didn't know, he is the founder of the Ig Nobel Prizes. And he said the following to me: "What do you mean by you want to be a science communicator? You already are one." Now, whilst I'm sure this would have been said to anyone, it made me start thinking seriously about starting something up this year. And this is where the person I am definitely most grateful to comes in. My wonderful friend Mina. She has been so unbelievably and incredibly motivating, supportive, and encouraging from day minus one. Her words were, "So, you've been wanting to do that for so long, why haven't you started yet?" So she helped me come up with the name Draw Curiosity, and she promptly made me buy the domain, get the YouTube page, the Facebook page, get back into Twitter. Basically, get started. And I gave myself 5 months to launch the channel. 5 months might sound like a really long time to launch a YouTube channel, but I worked very hard in that time. I laid out the website just the way I wanted it, I invested in a camera bag, and I made myself take my DSLR out so I could learn how to use it properly. I learned how to edit and animate in the software that I switched to. There were many other logistics as well, such as finding the right music and the art. Huge shout out to Cryosleep Kitten, whose music is the background music to every science video, and to Thastor, whose Mystic House song Johnson is Draw Curiosity's theme tune. I'm also incredibly grateful and humbled that incredible artist and friend Caruaro and animator Cristina Emanuel worked together to put together the channel art and the characteristic intro animation to this channel. I love it so much, and it always inspires me to make sure any video I publish lives up to it. And of course, I also practice my science communication. I entered several competitions, perhaps most notably I entered FameLab and I made it through to the regional phase. I discovered that I was equally thrilled and terrified about talking science to an audience, and since then I've joined Toastmasters and I've signed up to every speaking gig I could. So I'm happy to say that I am no longer nervous before giving a talk, and in fact I think talking to a live audience is now one of my favourite things to do. I am really, really grateful to everyone who's supported me alongside this endeavour from the start. My friends, my parents, Joe, and all of you who have offered support and feedback in some way. I also discovered that I really love the process of making videos, and perhaps the most pleasant surprise of all is discovering the other side of YouTube. How lovely the community that watches science videos on the internet is. I mean, I love making videos, but to an audience like you, it's honestly my pleasure. Draw Curiosity always grew quicker than I expected it to, but I would definitely say the tipping point was pitching and creating the guest video for Tom Scott. So thank you so much, Tom. Draw Curiosity went from just shy of a humble hive of around 400 lovely people to a colony of over 10,000 equally delightful people in a week. And I'm thankful to every single one of you. All of you who watch any of my stuff, those who subscribed, who click those thumbs uppy buttons, but particularly those of you who comment and share my stuff. I have never seen as many lovely and intelligent comments as I have in my comment section, nor so many nice people actually trying to answer each other and spread knowledge. It blows my mind and I love it. So again, thank you so much. I was forewarned that I'd probably get lots of mean people on my channel, and I'm actually used to people being mean because I used to be bullied at school, but honestly, the worst egg on this channel wasn't really that bad, and they came well before the Tom Scott video, so it's all good. It's also very exciting that we reached 10,000 subscribers. It's a milestone I was hoping to reach someday, simply because at that point you can unlock the YouTube space, which means access to nice studio space and therefore better videos, and also the ability to enter YouTube next up. And unbelievably, Draw Curiosity achieved both of those things in 6 months. So you can expect some very nice episodes shot in the space early next year, as well as a few science travel vlogs, which will also cover the YouTube next up shenanigans. I actually still can't quite believe that either of those things happened, and I am so humbled and lucky and grateful, and thank you so much. And I'm not only grateful to you guys, you are pretty incredible, but I'm also very grateful to the absolutely lovely and welcoming community that the educational creators on YouTube are. YouTube creation has been far from an isolated endeavour. So thank you to everyone in WeCreateEDU, the Internet Creators Guild, and other various educational and SciComm oriented groups who have supported me and each other, who have been so lovely and welcoming. Everyone I've met, worked with, am working with, and will be working with. I don't dare actually mention names out of fear of missing someone out, but you all know who you are. It has been quite an incredible year. Not at all what I expected, and I am just so grateful. Of course, it's not always been roses and glory. I've definitely been more stressed and exhausted this year than I would have liked. Draw Curiosity isn't the only thing I'm working hard on. I'm also working on my PhD, which I'm hoping to hand in by the end of 2017, and that can occasionally be a lot more stressful than I care to admit. And some of you may also know that I have OCD, and this year I've been working extremely hard to overcome it. If any of you have gone through CBT and ERP to overcome an anxiety disorder, hopefully you will know what I mean by it is very hard work, but hopefully it will also be very rewarding as well. So it will be worth it in the end, but right now it's exhausting. And of course, in addition to that, life always has its natural ups and downs, but you know, that's just life, I think. But in spite of that, in spite of being a bit more stressed and exhausted than is ideal, I'm really proud and satisfied with how hard I've worked this year and that the hard work is actually paying off. So again, thank you very much for sharing this journey with me. And anyway, that's kind of enough sentimental soppiness from me. I do want to discuss plans for the next year. Next year is going to be pretty tricky. I'm aiming to hand in my PhD by the end of the year because my funding is going to be running out pretty soon, and that means that I might have to slow things down in the latter half of the year. So my plan is to shoot a lot of episodes over summer and then release them gradually to cover that busy period whilst I'm writing up. However, I do promise that once I've done everything I can to ensure that I become Dr. Dawson, I will be back in full force. But that said, the start of the year will be pretty exciting. I've already got quite a few episodes filmed, so I just need to edit them, publish them. I'll be playing catch up, posting everything shot at the YouTube space, interspersed with some science themed blogs, which I'm very excited about. They cover from when my friend John from Stated Clearly came to visit and we scienced away in London, an event with EDF Energy, and of course the YouTube Next Up. I also have a few collaborations and a few even more new episodes that I've been writing and preparing, so it should definitely be a fun year. I'm also possibly visiting CERN to shoot a couple of episodes, and we'll definitely be visiting VidCon Amsterdam in April, so if you happen to be going, please do come and say hi. Anyway, this has been a really long and self-indulgent video, and for some reason you're still here watching it. So a few people have asked me here and there if I have a Patreon. I don't, but I have been thinking about maybe releasing one in 2017, or maybe after handing in. I've got quite a lot to think about, but I do have a question for you. What are your thoughts on Patreon? If you wanted to support Draw Curiosity, which by the way will always be free, what type of perks would you want? As always, I would love to hear your thoughts and thank everyone who's watched till the end. I appreciate all of you, so thank you for making my 2016 a pretty snazzy one. And here's a happy toast to you for a wonderful 2017.